स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम टेकिंग योर पेपर, बॉटनी पेपर फर्स्ट फॉर सेमिस्टर फर्स्ट. द कोड ऑफ आवर पेपर इज BO231. नाउ लेट अस सी फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द सिलेबस ऑफ आवर पेपर. द फर्स्ट टॉपिक इज इंट्रोडक्शन टू एंजियोस्पर्म टैक्सोनॉमी. अंडर दैट देर आर सब यूनिट्स, डेफिनेशन, स्कोप, ऑब्जेक्टिव्स एंड इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ टैक्सोनॉमी, एक्सप्लोरेशन, description, identification, nomenclature and classification, and last one is that concept of systematics with brief historical background. Our second topic is that systems of classification. Under that, comparative account of various systems of classification we have to study here: artificial system by Carolus Linnaeus, natural system by Bentham and Hooker, phylogenetic system by Engler and Prandtl, and APG system, a brief review. Third topic is the study of plant families. Total we have to study 10 families. Study of following families with reference to systematic position as per the Bentham and Hooker's systems of classification: silent features, floral formula, floral diagram, and any 5 examples with their economic importance. And in this topic we have to study the family Anunaceae, Brassicaceae, Myrtaceae, Rubiaceae, Solanaceae, Apocynaceae, Nyctaginaceae, and Amyridaceae. Topic number 4, botanical nomenclature. Under this topic, we have to study concept of nomenclature, brief history, binomial nomenclature, international code for nomenclature of algae, fungi, and plants, principles, rules and recommendations, type specimen and its types: halotype, parasites, isotype, lectotype, neotype, and concept of typification, ranks and ending of taxa names, coining of genus and species names, single, double and multiple authority citation. Fifth topic is that introduction to ecology. Now these 4 topics are related to the angiosperm taxonomy, and another section is starting from topic number 5, that is introduction to ecology. Under this topic we have to study definition of ecology, concept, scope and interdisciplinary approach. Autoecology and synecology, species diversity, definition, concept, scope and types, alpha, beta and gamma diversity, methods of vegetation sampling: quadrat method, transect method, plotless method, genetic diversity, definition, nature and origin of genetic variations. Next point, species diversity, definition, origin of species diversity, diversity indices, species abundance, ecosystem diversity. Under that definition, major ecosystems, types of the world. Hotspots in India, concept and basis of hotspot identification. And as per our syllabus, last topic is that ecological grouping of plants. Under this topic, we have to study here ecological grouping of plants with reference to their significance of adaptive, external and internal features of hydrophytes, mesophytes, xerophytes, halophytes with examples. Now this is our syllabus. Now let us start the first topic, introduction to angiosperm. In FIVSC we have studied that outline classification of the plant kingdom. Under that there is the 2 groups, cryptogames and phanerogames. Under cryptogames we have studied algae, fungi, bryophyte, pterophyte, lichens. And higher group of the plant kingdom is nothing but the phanerogames. It is also called spermatophyta. Sperma means seeds and phyton means the plant. That means the spermatophyta. Under that spermatophyta or phanerogames, phanerogames mean the flowering plants. Under that there are 2 major groups, angiosperm and gymnosperm. Gymnosperm is nothing but the naked seeded plants, and our topic is nothing but the higher group, angiosperm. Under that the first chapter is introduction to angiosperm taxonomy, under which we have to see definition, scope, objectives and importance of taxonomy, exploration, description, identification, nomenclature and classification. And lastly, we have to study here concept of systematic with brief historical background. Now, first of all, let us see that introduction, definition of taxonomy. Plant taxonomy is the fundamental branch of botany. It is a science by which biologists classify and organize the vast diversity of living things on this planet. It gives understand the evolutionary relationship between them. Taxonomy is a theory and practice of classifying organisms. It plays major role in conservation, protection, and utilization of biodiversity, recognizing and interpreting similarities and differences. Now let us see first of all the definition. Taxonomy is defined as the study of classification, identification, description, and nomenclature of plants. Simply meaning is that lawful arrangement or arrangement by the rules. Now in this slide, the science of taxonomy or classification consists of classifying, identifying, and assigning living things to group based on their similarities in anatomical structures. Scientists use scientific names to signify into what groups living thing belong. The extant angiosperm, that is the flowering plants, are one of the major group of all seal plants. It is highly evolved group with at least 260,000 living species classified in 453 families. Plant taxonomy is the practice and science of classification. The word find its root in the Greek taxis, meaning order or arrangement. Taxis means arrangement and nomos means rules and regulation, or it is also called science. The word taxonomy was first of all used by the botanist A.P. D. Kendall. He is well known botanist. In 1983, first of all the taxonomy word utilized by the scientists in 1813. The word can be defined as the science of classifying plants, animals and microorganisms into increasingly broader categories based on shared features. Traditionally, organisms were grouped by physical resemblance, but in recent times other criteria such as genetic matching have also been used. More precisely, plant taxonomy can be defined as taxonomy is the branch of biology which deals with the description, identification, classification, and naming of plants according to their resemblance and differences. Next point is that scope of taxonomy. Taxonomy actually is related to each and every branch of the botany. Now these are the scope in establishing the phylogenetic relationships that exist naturally between many groups of plants. Using nomenclature, principles and rules, all plants are named. Now this is one of the aspects of taxonomy, nomenclature. Nomenclature means to give the two name system to the plants. It is also called binomial nomenclature system. And there are some rules and regulation according to the ICBN, International Code of Botanical Nomenclature. It has great value in forestry because all forests have been named and classified. It has wide importance in agriculture, horticulture, etc. The study of ecology, the knowledge of taxonomy and systematic botany became essential. Plant ecologists must be aware of the names of the plants and their relationships to habit and the environment. Objectives of the taxonomy. There are so many objectives. The main objectives of taxonomies are identification, nomenclature, and classification of plants. The objectives of modern taxonomy are to provide convenient method of identification and communication. Second one, it provide classification system based on natural affinities of organisms. To provide an inventory of plant taxa by means of floras, monographs, manuals, etc. Next one, to store the knowledge of past and present plants. Now here, inventory of world fauna. To provide method for identification and communication. taxonomy to produce a coherent and unified system of classification. Next one, to demonstrate the evolutionary implications of plant diversity. To provide a single Latin scientific name for every group of plants in the world, both living and fossils or extinct. To arrange in such a way as to give us an idea about the sequence of their evolution from simpler, earlier and more primitive type to more complexes, more recent, more advanced type in different periods of industry. Now let us see what is the importance of taxonomy. Taxonomy aims to classify living creatures. There are millions of organisms on the earth of different physical, physiological, regional differences. Taxonomy helps to classify these millions of organisms scientifically into some categories, like from genus, species, order, family, subdivision, division, and lastly kingdom level. That steps are called hierarchical levels. And it is very important to study and understand the naming of the plant or classification of the plant. Taxonomy helps to ascertain the number of living species on the earth. We have discovered till now some thousands of plants and animal species and are recorded as per the rules and regulations of taxonomy. Taxonomy helps in getting an idea to the student of what type of characters are present in the plants and animals possesses even before seeing or study them in detail. For example, is described below. In plants, when one hears a plant to be leguminous family, plant belong to leguminous family, the characters we can ascertain are that they have nitrogen synthesizing bacteria in the root nodules. They have seed which can be broken into exact two half. Next important is that taxonomy gives an idea levels of physical development. Taxonomy gives an idea of how far animal has physical and mental development and its position in the evolution tree of organisms. For example, here when you hear the word bacteria, you get an idea of single cell organism and fungi as multicellular organism. Both two groups are belong to the cryptogames, that means the non-flowering plant. Yet both are microbes. Physically and evolutionary wise, but fungi are advanced than the bacteria. Fungi are microscopic or macroscopic also. That's why they are more advanced, more evolutionary idea characters are present than the bacteria. Taxonomy gives an idea of local fauna. Not all plants and animal species are found in all regions of the earth. Now this is scope and importance of taxonomy. Now let us see concept of systematics. Systematics is commonly defined as the study of biological diversity and the relationships among the organisms. Taxonomy and systematics are not clearly separable, and both are frequently used interchangeably by biologists. Here, systematics is commonly defined as the study of biological diversity and the relationships among organisms. Taxonomy and systematics are not clearly separable. One of the well-known botanists, Masson, in 1950 considered taxonomy has the vast field including main four streams. That is study of organisms, taxonomic systems, nomenclature and their documentation. Systematic deals with how organism and taxa are related in natural habitats. Next concept, systematic plays a role in biology by providing in the means of characterize the organism that we study. Taxonomy restricted to the study of classification. Then one of the well-known botanists, Jones and Luesinger, in 1987 believed that There is no agreement among the botanists for distinction between systematics and taxonomy. Some botanists treat them as two separate branches. According to these botanists, systematics is the study of diversity of plants and their identification, naming, classification and evolution, while taxonomy is restricted to the study of classification. This is the concept of systematics. Thank you.